So how do you make awesome looking custom thumbnails that get you more views on your YouTube videos, even if you don't have any graphic design knowledge at all? I'm gonna show you how in this quick and easy tutorial right now. Hey, what's up guys? Sean here with Video Influencers, helping you build your influence, income, and impact with online video. And on this channel, we do interviews with video influencers, as well as tips and strategy videos, just like this one. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. But as you know, custom thumbnails are one of the most important parts of actually getting people to watch your videos and for having success on YouTube in general. But it can be hard to make thumbnails like the pros. So let's jump into some quick and easy tips right now. And hey, before we jump over and make the thumbnail, we're gonna talk about how to take a screenshot from your video and use that for your thumbnail. But the very best thing that you can do is to take a separate photo intentionally for your thumbnail. So first, I'm gonna take a couple photos with my smartphone that we're gonna be able to use in the thumbnail. Okay guys, so like I said, the first thing that we're gonna do here is we can grab a screenshot of a video. Now I'm using the snipping tool and I'm on a PC. You could do a screen capture and capture the whole screen. I'm just gonna snip a picture of a frame of a paused YouTube video. Your best place to do this might be actually in your video editing software or making your video full screen if you wanted to grab a screenshot like this. Next, you want to jump over to canva.com, and Canva is entirely free. It is a super cool design site, and that's where we're gonna design our custom thumbnail. Starting here on this screen, once you're signed up for your account, say use custom dimensions, and what you wanna do is do 1920 by 1080. That is HD resolution dimensions, and that is gonna be the dimensions of your custom thumbnail. So just put those numbers in there. And then what you wanna do is you can go to uploads and upload either the photos from a custom thumbnail shoot where you take some intentional photos, or the screenshot. So with that screenshot there, you can see that one here, and all you gotta do is just drag it in and you could scale it up and then put text on there and use your screenshot however you want. But I'm gonna use one of these photos from the shoot I just did just now sitting here with my iPhone. And this is just shows you can make good thumbnails even without necessarily like a great camera, because it's the front facing camera of my iPhone and it's not even the greatest quality. And so I was able to just put those in there. But one of the things I'd recommend is that if you have a DSLR or something, that you take some high quality photos for your thumbnail. And the first thing that you want to do is you actually want to make it a little more contrasty. You want to up the saturation and you want to sharpen it. And the way you do that on Canva is if you go to the blur tool, if you go that way, it makes it blurry. But if you go the other way, it makes it sharper. And there's been research done and stuff to say that thumbnails are more effective if they're about 30% oversaturated and 30% over sharpened. Because it's so small, you want the image really to pop. It's not gonna be this big, right? And there's my crazy face. Sorry about that. But okay, so then what you can do is you can add text. And the way I like to make my text really pop out and be readable is by adding a shape first. And so in this case, we could bring in a nice rounded corner box here and put a shape where our text is gonna go. And then we could change the color of it. You could add extra colors and maybe grab like a dark gray shape or something just like that. And then what we can do is grab our text and simply put it in here with whatever our video is about. And so I usually like to do kind of block text, but of course, whatever your style is. And we could say weird trick for YouTube. Kind of matches my face, and change the text to white and we should be good to go. Now, a couple principles for good thumbnails is you don't want to use too many words, right? Because it's so small, you want it to be as kind of big and readable as possible. So there you go. And one other thing that you can check out on Canva is that if you go over to the search bar here, you could come up with, and just search YouTube, you could come up with cool designs and cool shapes and stuff. So you actually could bring in like a logo and maybe put this down here. And that could be like kind of sitting on my hand, even though my hand kind of got cut off, and then we could get rid of this text. Boom, there you go. And what I, like I said, what I like to do is usually have like a nicer image for the thumbnail that we actually take intentionally. So this kind of gives you a look into our world with like what Benji and I would do for a video influencer shoot is we would put a camera on a timer on the DSLR and shoot custom, intentional photos that are gonna be used for our thumbnails, right? So in this case, you could go weird trick for, or just weird trick because the YouTube logo's on there. Yeah, all right. And then that can just be moved down here. You could rotate it a little bit. And like I always like to do, I think that having it be really readable is important. And one of the best ways to do that is to probably throw an element behind it that just really makes it pop on the page. And then what you do is just click on this and say back, and it sends that to the back. YouTube, weird trick. And just like the other photo, even if it is with your DSLR, go ahead and sharpen it up a little bit, up the saturation a little bit, contrast, can maybe move the image around, and there we go. YouTube weird trick. And then all you got to do is say download and say high quality image, and that'll save to your computer. Just click save, and then we'll cut over to my media channel. And so we're inside Creator Studio, and we're on the videos themselves, and we're in the place where you'd edit your stuff. Of course, you have your default three options to pick thumbnail, or your change icon custom thumbnail right here. Go to your folder and pick out the thumbnail that you want to upload, which would be this one. And then that one would update right there if I wanted to change this thumbnail. Now, just in case you don't have this option here, one thing that you need to do is turn on your account for monetization. So if you go to YouTube settings and go to view additional features, you want to make sure that your account is set up for monetization right here. Once it is, it doesn't actually mean you have to monetize your videos. It just means monetization needs to be turned on. And so once that's turned on, then the ability to do custom thumbnails will show up on your channel.
So hey, before you go, I wanna let you know about one more thing. Custom thumbnails will definitely help your videos, but they are just one part of overall YouTube success. And so a lot of you've probably already downloaded our free guide, but if you haven't yet, it's a checklist for 19 things to do every time you upload a YouTube video. And it'll help your videos get more views and help your channel get more subscribers. And so I'll link that up on the YouTube card and put it in the description below. So definitely check that out. But hey, you are ready to make custom thumbnails. And remember, it's always best if you can take some posed shots during your video shoot so that you've got a really nice photo for your custom thumbnails, and then just use free software with canva.com. Two questions of the day, optional. Number one, what kind of videos are you creating on YouTube, and are you gonna be using these thumbnails for? And the second question is, maybe you have a different software, a different way you create custom thumbnails. I'd love to hear about it in the YouTube description. And as always, some of the best tips and conversation happens from the video influencers community in the YouTube comments, so make sure to connect down there. So hey, thanks so much for checking out this video. Definitely subscribe for more videos just like this one. And don't forget to download the 19 tips checklist as well. That'll be helpful. And hey, if you appreciated this video, I would appreciate if you hit the like button. And until next time, keep crushing it, and we will talk soon.
Oh, my back hurts. Oh, it's been a shoot day. I'm in the middle of a batch shooting day and I'm exhausted. But hey, if you haven't seen the video on consistency, batching is one of the tips. YouTube card will link to that video if you've never seen it.